So my name is Ramrup Das. Right now I'm the head teacher of Jihu Temple. Since my childhood I was always looking for happiness. So I thought if I did engineering then I'll be very happy. But after doing engineering I was not happy. Then I thought if I get a proper job I'll be happy. Then finally after some frustration, actually I finished my mechanical engineering from Andhra University in 1987. Then after 1 year wait, I got a job in Mumbai, that is in Ministry of Defense, Directorate General of Quality Assurance. So I joined here in Mumbai in Vikhroli office in 1988 May. After 2-3 months work, I realized that I'm not happy here. Then I wanted to change my job and all. So I have been trying very hard to change my job, but I was not so successful. So when I was in, then what happened suddenly, from Delhi headquarters, they have requested our office people to send some candidates for some training in computers. Somehow my name was listed. So it was a sudden decision. So during that was during Diwali time, 1988. So I was ordered to go there to Delhi immediately. So then I went to Mumbai Central because I didn't get any reservation. So I paid that time 100 rupees to one porter. Then he put me in one general compartment in Frontier Mail. So somehow I managed to sit there and go. So the whole day actually, because it is in general compartment, if I leave the my berth, I would lose it. That's why I didn't move at all. And then the whole day I did not eat only. So finally when the train came to Mathura station, I thought I'll drink some tea because I was feeling hungry. So I got down at Mathura station and I was drinking tea. And suddenly somehow it flashed in my mind that I should get down in Mathura station and go and see Krishna's birthplace. I don't know how it occurred to me. So because since my childhood I heard about Mathura and Vrindavan and all from my parents, from my grandmother and all, I thought I will go there. So in a luckily what happened, in Delhi I wanted to see some sightseeing and all. So 2 days earlier only I started like that. Then I immediately rushed to the compartment. I packed up my picked up my luggage and then got down at Mathura station like unscheduled arrival in Mathura. So then I was thinking where to go. Then suddenly I said, okay, I will go to Vrindavan. So this also just came like that. So that time there was single gauge trains are there from Mathura to Vrindavan. So I took a ticket and sat there in the train. The train was waiting. So I was waiting for the train to leave for Vrindavan. So meanwhile one sadhu came and sat beside me. Then he asked me, where do you want to go? I said, I want to go to Vrindavan. Then he asked me, why you want to go to Vrindavan? I don't know. It just occurred to me that I should go to Vrindavan. So where are you planning to stay? I said, I have no idea. I don't know. I never went to Vrindavan. Then he kindly offered me, we have got ashram. You come and stay with us. No problem. So like that, somehow I blindly believed that sadhu. And then I went with him. So he kept me in one room in his ashram. Then he told, you take rest, I will call you for dinner. So that was almost 8 o'clock in the night. So I told him, since morning I have not eaten anything, give me something to eat, otherwise I am facing a lot of difficulty. So sadhu told, okay. Then he went, he brought some fruits and some sweets and say, take this and take bath and take rest. 12 o'clock in the night, there is some program. So we'll wake you up and then you can attend that program. Then after that, you will get prasad. So I got I got up and then they called me. Then that main sadhu, the main ashram in charge, he told me that today you are very fortunate. Today is a very auspicious day. You came on a very auspicious day. So that is actually happened to be Kartik month. So I went. So next day morning, I got up. Then I asked, what are the places to see? Then they said, there are so many temples, Shat Goswami temples and all. So I hired a rickshaw and then I went to all the temples. But at the time, that was, I'm around 23, 24 at the time. So I was not so interested so much in temples and all. But somehow I was going through motions. Then finally when the I hired the rickshaw for all the temples for 60 rupees at that time. And when final temple came, then I asked, is there any other temple? Then he said, there is Angreji temple is there. If you want me to take you there, it will take 15 rupees extra. So even now also, they call our Krishna Balaram temple as Angreji temple. I said, no problem, take me. So I went there. So first time when I saw our Krishna Balaram temple, I really become very fascinated. Especially when I went to Srila Prabhupada's quarters, I felt Srila Prabhupada as if he was alive. So I took, that time I had a passion for photography, so I was carrying my camera also. So I took some photographs of Srila Prabhupada. So later on when I went to the temple, I really liked it. Then I took the photographs of Krishna Balaram, Radha Shyamsundar and Gauranitha. Of course, I don't know who they were at the time, but I still took. Then when I came out, then outside there is a bookstore. So there is one foreign lady, she was sitting there and distributing books. So at the time, as being young, I was trying to flirt with that lady. So I was talking to her and all. Then she asked me to take Bhagavad Gita. So I told my suitcase was packed. So that time Bhagavad Gita is very hardbound, very heavy edition. So then she told very punchline, like, you know, very impressive statement she made, saying that the knowledge in this book is also very heavy, she told me. So I was very impressed by what she said, and I took that Bhagavad Gita as it is. Then I packed my, I packed it, and then I came, I went to Delhi, then came back to Mumbai. So that was in 88 November. So since then, that Bhagavad Gita as it is lying in my shelf. Sometimes I used to take it out and read it, but I never took it very seriously. Only when 1991, my frustration with my job increased like anything. I became very frustrated in my life. I was wondering what happened. Then I was alone. I was feeling lonely and all that. So in 1991, I applied for one job in Mumbai Port Trust. So I was hoping that I would get that job, but I didn't get it, and I was very frustrated. So in that great frustration, one day in 91 January, I was thinking what to do with my life. Then at the time, I picked up Bhagavad Gita as it is from the shelf, that is gathering dust, for 3 years. So I started reading Bhagavad Gita. So previously also I used to read some few pages, but at that time, in January 1991, so I started reading Bhagavad Gita. At one stretch, I read 11 chapters in 1 or 2 months time. Then it's like Jnanodaya happened, means self-realization happened. Then I started enjoying and relishing reading Bhagavad Gita as it is. So at that time, after reading Bhagavad Gita, I understood that I should have a spiritual master in my life. So I was, at that time only, I was reading another book, autobiography of a yogi. So from that book, one thing I gleaned from the book is, you know, if you want a guru, you should pray to Krishna. So I was praying to Krishna, please send me to a bona fide spiritual master. So one day, sometime on May 26th or 27th, 1991, I was standing at King Circle Station, railway station, planning to go to VT to watch some movie. Then suddenly I felt, what is this lonely life and going alone to movie and all. So instead of going to VT station, I came to ISKCON Mandir that time. So of course previously also I used to come to the temple with my friends to Juhu Beach. From Juhu Beach I used to come to Radhanaswari temple, and we are very fond of eating masala vada, medu vada and masala chai. Then sometimes we would even take darshan also, we just go away like that. So but that day I came specifically to meet some devotees. So at the temple entrance there was a board was there that become a devotee. So I went and told that I want to become a devotee. So that devotee thought that I want to be full-time devotee. Then he asked me about my education background and all. Then I told that I am a BE mechanical. So he guided me to Bhaktivedanta Institute, because that time they were only doing youth preaching a lot. So he guided me. So in Bhaktivedanta Institute I met Radhakant Prabhu first time. So he took me inside and he taught me, he explained everything. Then he told me to attend Mangalarti. He said, come on Friday evening, stay here. Then you attend Mangalarti on Saturday morning. Then you will enjoy it, you will like it. So I went to the temple on Monday. Then during the time, then I told some of my colleagues and friends in my office that, you know, I am going to ISKCON. Stay there, but they all frightened me, saying that ISKCON has got bad name and they will, you know, take you and then they will sell off your kidneys, this, that, all that, so many things. They frightened me. By the time, then Friday evening till 6 o'clock, I was wondering whether to go or not. Then finally I said, okay, my life is anyway spoiled, it's not going anywhere, let it, anything happen. Let me take the risk and go there. So I finally came on Friday night. So that is on 30th May. Then June 1st, 1991. First time I attended Mangalarti. So when I first had darshan of Shri Shri Radharas Bihari on that day, when I was attending Mangalarti, there is some wave of, I experienced some sort of a wave of happiness in my heart. Then finally I said, okay, I got what I wanted throughout my life, experiencing happiness. So next day, later on they taught me how to chant Hare Krishna. So for, it became an addiction. Every Friday I would come, attend, stay here in Hare Krishna temple, and attend Mangalarti, then attend Guru Puja. Then I started reading books, then I started chanting Hare Krishna mantra. So that time Mukund Madha Prabhu, Rishabhdev Prabhu, Prem Bhakti Prabhu, they were in BIS. They used to take care of me very nicely and everybody. Then Rasraj Prabhu was the main, he was the director at Bhaktivedanta Institute. So on 1st of June only, he was sitting there. Then I was there and then he asked about me. And then I said, I had one question. So he said, yeah, what? Then directly from 9th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, I asked one question, you know, Apichaya Sudharacharya. Then he was shocked, right? First time you are asking me, and then you are asking me this question. Now, like that, I made friendship with many devotees and BI. Then slowly, I started chanting 16 rounds. But at the time, I was staying alone, and then I used to eat in hotels. So meanwhile, I was hearing that one, a devotee should take only prasad. So I was wondering what to do, because I used to take in my canteen every day in my office mess. So Anik Galik was there. So So one day I was sitting in the one restaurant near in Vikhroli, and I was just crying, "Oh my dear Lord, somehow or other make some arrangement so that I can take prasad." So throughout my life, my father actually was an engineer, and we are all well off. We used to have 2-3 servants at our house. So I never did any household chores in my life. I didn't even boil water any time in my life. So, but somehow on that day night, the Lord in my heart inspired that, you know, you better cook for yourself if you want to take prasad. So next day morning, I told the landlady. She was also from Telugu, Andhra. So I told her, you know, I want to cook, can you teach me? Because I don't know anything. She said, no problem. So I went to the other market and then purchased stove and all the utensils and all that. Then I started cooking myself and offered to Krishna. So this is one miracle that happened in my life. So later on when I went home, I told my mother, I'm not going to eat food cooked by you because all of you eat Anandali. I said, I'm going to cook for all of you. So when I cooked for all of them, they were all amazed to taste the prasad because it was so delicious. I know because somehow I used to pray to Srimati Radharani to help me cook very nicely for Krishna. So it used to come up very nicely. So that was a very great realization I had in the early part of my life. So later on, one day, on one of the Sundays, after taking prasad, I was sitting in BI library. So this Prabhupada Lilamrita first part, A Lifetime in Preparation, was lying there on the table. So I took that book and I was going through a few pages because previously I was a voracious reader. I used to read a lot of novels. So I was, for long hours I can read. So I was going through this book and I liked it so much. Then I started reading from the first page. Then I was reading, and at 10 o'clock I started reading that book. Then I could not keep that book away, and then in between I was crying a lot, you know, reading about Srila Prabhupada's struggles and all. Then by the time I finished that book, it is night, 10 o'clock in the night. So entire first volume I finished in one day. Then I was so overwhelmed and impressed by Srila Prabhupada's life and his teachings. Then I have decided I will dedicate my life to this great personality. Then I took the second volume, third volume, fourth volume. Then being a government job, I was not so much hassle for work. It was not such an easy job. We didn't have so much work. You know, then it's a government job, so we didn't have to work hard so much also. So I used to read Prabhupada Lilamrita sitting in my office. So like that, almost sometime around February 1992, when I was going to Mayapur, before that, Rasraj Prabhu, that time BI director, he called me and told me one very interesting thing, that don't spoil your life, you know, working for these Karmis, materialistic people. You work for Krishna. Then he told, whenever, during Prabhupada's time, very few Indians who are engineers and doctors joined Hare Krishna temple. So Srila Prabhupada is very pleased whenever an Indian engineer or a doctor joined Hare Krishna Mandir. So he said, Srila Prabhupada told that when Indian engineers and doctors distribute my books, I feel that my movement is very successful. So I was very impressed by the words of Rasraj Prabhu. Then I seriously started contemplating to join full time. So, but at home there was a lot of resistance. My father, he was threatening that he will complain to the police, he will file suit against ISKCON and all that stuff. But somehow I was so determined. So meanwhile in the office also, when my officer saw that I was always spending my time reading Srila Prabhupada books in the office, then he called me that you choose, you know, you are working for government but you are doing something else, so you choose, you want to be devotee or you want to, you know, continue as a in your job. then I decided, okay, if I can cheat, then let me join. So finally, in 1992 May, I went home. I didn't tell, of course, my parents that I'm going to join, but a few things, whatever gold and all, necklace and chain and all, I had. I gave it to my sister and all, because she was expected to get married at that time. So then I came back, and then on the 17th June 1992, I moved into the temple. So later on, my father and all, they were not knowing like that. I joined. So then I didn't inform at my office also. So then they started sending mails to my house, asking me about my whereabouts, where is your son, like that. So then finally they filed a police complaint against me, because it's being a defense department, declared me as a deserter, and the police, Jugu police came. So that time Rajan Prabhu was a guest house manager, they came and met him. So he called me and explained. So then I said, okay. So then the police threatened me that, you know, next time I'll come with the arrest warrant, go and report in your office. So I went to the office, and then Colonel, he explained to me, Shivaram, you think about once again, because this is a government job, and it's very, very difficult to get a job again. You are taking a great risk like that. But somehow I was so convinced by Krishna consciousness, by Shri Prabhupada's teachings. So I was not at all fearful to resign. So that day I resigned and came. Then my father came to know that I joined. Then the hell broke out. But by the time it was too late, they could not do anything. So since then, as soon as I entered, joined the temple, I was in BI, doing cashier job and all. Then we started college preaching. So later on, I became a life membership preacher. So till 1999, I was doing service in BI. Then 1999, I became IWAP director. And 2001, I became head pujari of Hare Krishna temple. It was a great experience, because I never thought that one day I'll become head pujari, because right from the day one, I was very attached to the deities, and I used to spend hours standing in front of the deities, chanting Hare Krishna, thinking about them. So I never knew that one day I'll be doing dressing and all, Shunga. But somehow 1996 onwards, I started doing dressing. So meanwhile, 1994 I got initiated. Then 96 I got second initiation. Then since 2001 I am doing service as head pujari. I do college preaching, house preaching also. So like this, it was a great experience. Throughout my stay for last 23 years in ISKCON, I never felt, even for one day, I never regretted my decision to join Hare Krishna. Actually, it was a very smooth ride. So far, so good. I met great devotees in the movement. There were some up and downs were there, but I knew if I stick around, I will definitely sail along. My only experience, I do a lot of collection for the temple. So many devotees, some devotees, they ask me, how do you do that? So my only answer is, have good sadhana, have faith in Krishna, then Krishna will definitely guide you in the service. So my strong belief that if you have good sadhana, that means waking up early in the morning for Mangala Arati, chanting 16 rounds, following for great principles, every day attending Bhagavatam class, and read Bhagavatam at least for 1 hour. If you do all these things, whatever failures you may face, whatever frustrations you may face, you can come out very strong with the help of good sadhana. So this is my experience in Hare Krishna movement. Hare Krishna. Came to Mathura station. I thought I'll drink some tea because I was feeling hungry. So I got down at Mathura station and I was drinking tea. And suddenly somehow it flashed in my mind that I should get down in Mathura station and go and see Krishna's birthplace. I don't know how it occurred to me. So because since my childhood I heard about Mathura and Vrindavan and all from my parents, from my grandmother and all, I thought I will go there. So in a luckily what happened, in Delhi I wanted to see some sightseeing and all, so 2 days earlier only I started like that. Then I got the, I immediately rushed to the compartment, I packed up my picked up my luggage and then got down it Mathura station, like unscheduled depart, like arrival in Mathura. So then I was thinking where to go, where to go. Then suddenly I said, okay, I will go to Vrindavan. So this also I just came like that. So that time there was single gauge trains are there from Mathura to Vrindavan. So I went, I took a ticket and sat there in the train. The train was waiting. So I was waiting for the train to leave for Vrindavan. So meanwhile one sadhu came, that was during Diwali time, 1988. So I was ordered to go there to Delhi immediately. So then I went to Mumbai Central because I didn't get any reservation. So I paid that time 100 rupees to one porter. Then he put me in one general compartment in Frontier Mail. So somehow I managed to sit there and go. So the whole day actually, because it is in general compartment, if I leave the my seat, my berth, I would lose it. That's why I didn't move at all. Then the whole day I did not eat only. So finally when the train joined here in Mumbai, in Vikhroli office in 1988 May, after 2-3 months work, I realized that I'm not happy here. Then I wanted to change my job and all. So I've been trying very hard to change my job, but I was not so successful. So when I was in, then what happened suddenly, from Delhi headquarters, they have requested our office people to send some candidates for some training in computers. Somehow my name was listed, so it was a sudden decision. So during so my name is Ram Rup Das. Right now I am the head pusher of Jihu Temple. Since my childhood I was always looking for happiness, so I thought if I did engineering then I'll be very happy, but after doing engineering I was not happy. Then I thought if I get a proper job I'll be happy. Then finally after some frustration, actually I finished my mechanical engineering from Andhra University in 1987. Then after 1 year wait I got a job in Mumbai, that is in Ministry of Defense, Directorate General of Quality Assurance.